Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, as we welcome you here to Georgetown College as we get ready to see the Georgetown College Lady Tigers take on the Martin Methodist Red Hawks. It's a beautiful day out here in Georgetown, Kentucky. We're about 50 degrees, cloudy, no sun, but also no rain, so that is good to hear. As we head into today's match, your Georgetown College record is 4-3 overall, with 2-3 in Mid-South Conference. However, they are 3-1 in their last four, with that one being that close loss to the number one team in the nation at that time, Lindsey Wilson. We'll be talking about that later in today's match. Today they play Martin Methodist with a record of 11-0 overall, 5-0 in conference, ranked number 5 in the nation. Martin Methodist coming in here today looking to continue their winning streak and hopefully their winning ways. However, today is senior day for your Georgetown College Lady Tigers as they're looking for a chance to beat the number 5 team in the nation and celebrate senior day in a fantastic way. We want to welcome you to today's broadcast. We're looking forward to today with you. My name is Matthew Longstreet, former senior captain of the Georgetown College men's soccer team, and I want to welcome you all. We're excited. Let's get started, and we'll be right with you here in just a couple moments. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you back here to Georgetown College as we get ready to start off with the announcements here for our seniors. We have multiple seniors here for the Georgetown College Lady Tigers that are going to be exiting as this will be their last home match. Again, we want to go ahead and start off with 00 Megan Martin. Megan Martin, a Highland Heights, Kentucky native, is being escorted by her parents, Michelle and Tim Martin. Heading into today's match, the goalkeeper has played 58 games with 55 starts with 331 saves to date. She most recently posted those 21 saves against number 13 Lindsey Wilson College to earn the Mid-South Conference and even the NAIA Defensive Player of the Week honor. The biology major plans to attend veterinary school and spend a life as adopting as many dogs and cats and horses as she possibly can. During her time at Georgetown, she has earned NAIA All-American Honorable Mention, All-Region, two-time Mid-South Conference, All-Conference, and three-time Mid-South Conference Player of the Week. She's also been on the Dean's List, a member of the Kappa Delta Leadership Society, Scholar Athlete, and Academic All-Conference. Megan's favorite Georgetown memory was beating the University of the Cumberlands in the conference tournament her sophomore year. Again, we want to say thank you to 00 Megan Martin. And our next player is number 8, Kelsey Castle. Kelsey Castle, a Mountain Washington, Kentucky native, is being escorted by her parents, April and Robert Castle. Heading into today's match, the defender has appeared in 34 games with 27 starts. The health science major plans to attend a physical therapy doctorate program while also completing her first marathon and getting more involved in CrossFit. During her time at Georgetown, she has earned Dean's List, Outstanding Senior in Health Science, Mid-South Conference All-Academic, and GC 2019 Leadership Award, and the 2018 Defensive MVP and 2018 Most Improved Player. Kelsey's favorite Georgetown memory is the time that Kitty and herself made their own slip and slide on the field after an away game at Rio Grande. The locker room, dance parties, and celebrations after beating the University of the Cumberlands in the tournament are also moments she'll never forget. We want to thank you, number 8, Kelsey Castle. And next up, we have number 10, Mackenzie Warner. Mackenzie Warner, a Plainfield, Indiana native, is being escorted by her mother, Heather Warner, and her father, Brian Warner. The psychology major with a Spanish and child development minor plans to attend a child life specialist program to continue a career in child life. She's earned Dean's List every semester since being here at Georgetown College. She's a Christian scholar and a member of Alpha Lambda Delta and also a part of the Kappa Delta Honor Society. Mackenzie's favorite Georgetown memory is playing soccer tennis every week and talking to Coach Castleman about their common love for chickens. And finally, when Beth Massey threw a pin through a light with an EpiPen. Number 10, Mackenzie Warner. Number 14, Olivia Ashby is our next senior. Olivia Ashby is a Louisville, Kentucky native. She's being escorted by her parents, Larry and Cammie Ashby. Heading into today's match, the forward has played in 41 games and starting 21 of those. The biomedical science major plans to attend medical school to become a general pediatrician or specialize in neonatology. During her time at Georgetown, she's earned a biology award, Women's Association of Georgetown College Award, and a COSIDA Academics Award, as well as Academic All-Conference, Dean's List, and Phi Kappa Phi. She has also received the Herbert Anderson Pre-Med and Robert T. Hinton Scholarship, and Olivia's favorite Georgetown memory is the overall opportunity to continue to play soccer along her best friends. Thank you, number 14, Olivia Ashby. And next up, we have number 16, Caroline Shy. Caroline Shy is a Shelbyville, Kentucky native and is being escorted by her parents, Ted and Allison Shy. The Communication and Marketing double major plans to work with hospitals and their community outreach and marketing programs. Caroline's favorite Georgetown memory is going undefeated her freshman year on the junior varsity team and celebrating with a cookie cake and cupcakes on the bus ride home as the team sang "All We Do Is Win" all the way home. Number 16, Caroline Shy. And last but not least, our last senior that we're going to be recognizing today is number 21, Kitty Lackey. Kitty Lackey is a Sebring, Florida native and is being escorted by her parents, TC and Kitty Lackey. Heading into today's match, the dual sport athlete playing both soccer and tennis for Georgetown has appeared in 12 games while battling multiple injuries in her three seasons. However, this biology major intends to graduate from school and pursue a career in the medical field. And during her time at Georgetown, she has earned the Mid-South Conference All-Academic and Scholar Athlete honors all her years. Kitty's favorite Georgetown memory is diving into the pools of water at the flooded soccer field at Rio Grande game, just the same as the other seniors. We want to thank you, number 21, Kitty Lackey. Ladies and gentlemen, go ahead and stand up. Give a round of applause for these seniors as we are going to wish them well, as this will be their final season here at Georgetown College. Well, they will be sorely missed, but we genuinely want to just say thank you to them. Thank you for their time, their effort, and their continuous ability to represent Georgetown College to the highest degree. These are your seniors, and as we get ready for today's match between Martin Methodist and Georgetown College, we've got 18 minutes. Go ahead, kick back, relax, grab whatever you need, and we'll see you back here in just a couple minutes. Thank you, seniors, and we'll see you here in just a bit.
Chris Brown. Set it up. Looking like a good time.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to Georgetown College as we get ready for today's match between your Georgetown College Lady Tigers and the Martin Methodist Redhawks. Your Georgetown College Tigers are coached by Leah Castleman. Currently, their record this year is overall 4-3 with a 2-3 record in Mid-South Conference. And in their last four, they are 3-1. Your Tigers are right now placed in the middle of the pack in the Mid-South Conference. And their opponent today is the Martin Methodist Redhawks, coached by Will Austin. And today he leads his Redhawks on a perfect 11-0 record, where they are also 5-0 in conference. Today is also senior day, so as your Tigers are looking to spoil the perfect record, Martin Methodist is looking to spoil the perfect senior day. So today we look forward to today's match. Just a couple things we just want to go ahead and touch on. Today's going to be interesting. Georgetown College is definitely looking for an opportunity here to try and get a big leg forward here in the Mid-South Conferences. Just a couple weeks ago, they played Lindsey Wilson. And in that game against Lindsey Wilson, a very high-powered offense was shut down. And in fact, Lindsey Wilson was only able to not in one goal, giving your Tigers a good opportunity to prove to the rest of the Mid-South Conference they're here to play. They're for real, and they're definitely chasing that Mid-South Conference title. However, Martin Methodist has been all gas this year. They have had no hiccups whatsoever. Talking to Coach Will Austin before the game today, he was mentioning to me how this team has been laser-focused since COVID. In fact, they saw it as an opportunity to bond, to get closer, to find opportunities to grow and become better players and better people. And with 11-0 record, I'd say he's definitely accomplished that. Today, the Martin Methodist Redhawks bring in two of the best players in all of NAIA. In fact, Yamasaki is a U-17 national team Japan captain when she was young, and she's walking into today's match leading the nation with 13 assists. And on the other side, we've got Libby Miller. Libby Miller is also one of the nation's leading scorers and assist givers as well, as she's got 5 goals this year and 3 assists. She's looking to use her speed to get ahead and possibly be able to net in a goal against this incredible team. Tigers definitely have their hands full today, but so do the Redhawks. As the Tigers are looking to upset the Redhawks today, the Redhawks are looking to continue their winning streak and hopefully win a Mid-South Conference regular season championship. But it's going to be interesting. Again, it's a cloudy day. It's a beautiful day for soccer. Everybody's ready. Everybody's geared up and ready to go as we get ready and geared up for today's match between your Georgetown College Lady Tigers and the Redhawks of Martin Methodist. Take a couple minutes here as we get ready for our national anthems and those begin. So you've got one last restroom break. Grab your snacks, grab your popcorn, and get ready. And we'll be with you here in just a couple minutes.
Here's how this will work. You'll watch this commercial, then look up Georgetown College. No, not that one. A Christian college in Kentucky. You'll be impressed with the school and your scholarship. You'll watch GC win yet another national championship with lifelong friends. You'll attend Oxford University. You'll take a class with that professor who blows your mind. You'll find your major and your career. You'll get internships and graduate, and your Georgetown degree will get you that first job or into grad school. You'll remember this as the moment that shaped your life. You're welcome. Think different. Think GC. Apply now at georgetowncollege.edu.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to today's match featuring the Redhawks of Martin Methodist College and your Georgetown Tigers. Let's meet the teams. For Martin Methodist, goalkeeper 72, Gabby Kennedy. 2, Sarah Casey. 3, Isabel Vasquez. 5, Jessica Glassman. 6, Lily Fisk. 8, Susuko Yamasaki. Number 9, Yuki Watari. Number 10, Adisa Ame. Number 12, Tabby Heaton. Number 14, Mackenzie Strobel. Number 19, Abby Madden. Redhawks are coached by Will Austin, assisted by Zach Kronauer. And now for your Georgetown Tigers! Number 0, in goal, Megan Martin! Number 3, Braylon Gant! Number 5, Bronwyn Hackney! Number 6, Abby Keaton! Number 8, Lizzie Pridmore. Number 10, Haven Locko. Number 21, Kitty Lackey. Number 22, Jalen Vaught. Number 24, Heidi Hilton. Number 26, Libby Miller. Number 29, Maggie Van Lewitt. We do have a correction. Number 8 is Kelsey Castle. Tigers are coached by Leah Cruz Castman. She's assisted by Elisa Craig, Bethany Massey, and Michael Stovick. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we honor America, our freedom, and the men and women in the armed forces around the world with the playing of our national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here to Georgetown College as we get ready here for the start of the Georgetown College women's soccer match between your Georgetown College Lady Tigers and the Martin Methodist Redhawks. Again, your Georgetown College Lady Tigers are looking for a big win today as they play against the number 5 team in the nation here. It's going to be an interesting task here for the Tigers. I know after talking to Leah Castleman, she had mentioned that, you know, against the Redhawks, they haven't had the best of history against them. However, the last time these two teams did meet was 3 years ago at Martin Methodist. Martin Methodist took the edge there 5-3, but a lot's happened since then. A lot of offense, a lot of change, as we all know as well, as we get ready for today's match between the Tigers and the Redhawks. One thing that we're definitely going to be looking for on the side of the Martin Methodist Redhawks is two players, very key for them. When it comes to offense and firepower, the two that they've got are Miss Yuki Watari and Yamasaki. Yuki Watari has 15 goals this year, number 1 in the nation when it comes to game-winning goals, and in fact, she's number 5 in the nation in goals per game, averaging 1.5. Yamasaki, however, she's number 1 in the nation in assists with 13 assists, and on top of that, she's number 2 in the nation in assists per game, averaging almost 2 assists per game. Those two are a dynamic duo from the country of Japan, as they're looking for an opportunity here to possibly take over here in the States. However, on the opposite side, as your Tigers are getting ready and ready to go, their high-powered offense between Miss Maddie Sparks and Libby Miller are definitely looking for an opportunity to get it on forward as they combine have over 10 goals together and close to 10 assists. We're getting started right away right here. It's out there on the left side there for Martin Methodist. Libby Miller tracking it down there. Castle looking for a quick clear. And Martin Methodist is already up in here, and good tackle there by Kelsey Castle. It's going to go out of bounds. Martin Methodist is looking to get forward as quickly as possible. I know talking to Will Austin, he said, I respect the back line, and I respect Meg Martin, especially after the incredible match she had against Lindsey Wilson, which is why we want to get out there fast, and we want to get out there quick while they're on their heels to possibly be able to put in a goal quickly. Corner taken there short. Cross there, and it's sky-high right over the bar there by number 9, Yuki Watari. That could be a moment we look back there to see. That could have been an opportunity there for Martin Methodist to take over. Georgetown's going to try and play out of their back here. Number 0 there, Meg Martin with the kick. And headed away there. Good control there by Georgetown. Gant has it now. Gant drops it back to Locko. And played forward looking for Van Lewitt there. And controlled by number 12, Hatim. Plays it out wide. You're going to see the attacking offense there for Martin Methodist looking for the combination between there on the side of Yamasaki. Good tackle there by Gant. Played out wide here by Martin. Redhawks control. Casey has it playing the long ball there. Sleek slips right through there. Looks like a good attack here for Yamasaki. She's looking for an opportunity, and it's just wide as Meg Martin. Looked like she had it covered, but Georgetown's going to have to be ready for that because Yamasaki, any moment she gets free, is a moment that there's definitely going to be a goal coming right around the corner. So Georgetown College defense already just reeling here just a little bit as it's been all Martin Methodist here in the opening couple minutes here. Van Lewitt looking for an opportunity there to get forward. Chased down by Lackey. And cleared forward there. Castle controls. And Yamasaki just quick, you can see, as this Martin Methodist pressure is just building forward. Gant has it now, looking for an opportunity to get forward. Yamasaki's all over her here. Good turn there by Gant. She's opening up there. Finds Hackney. Hackney loses it, though, and controlled well there by number 10, Among. Finds Yamasaki, but is quickly cut out there, and Castle is able to find the ball in control. She's looking to get forward, finding Gant. Gant has an opportunity here, looking for Van Lewitt. It's well cut out there by number 19, Madden. Yamasaki looking for an opportunity to get forward as she attacks Keaton. Watari looking to get it. Watari controls. Hackney in quick chase. Watari's got green space here. She finds Yamasaki. Yamasaki with a quick turn here. Looking for Watari. Yamasaki with a good turn there. Hackney in chase. Miller coming. Watari has it. Well controlled there by Gant. Good turn there by Van Lewitt, looking for an opportunity to get forward. Finding Keaton. Keaton playing it long there for Miller. And Miller's well cut out there. Martin Methodist not going to give Libby Miller any space. Talking to Will Austin before the match today, he said that Miller is one of the fastest players in NAIA, and any opportunity that they're going to be able to track her down, they're going to, even if it includes man marking or just having someone in front of her and behind her the entire match. So Libby Miller is going to have to be creative in the offensive third if she's going to be looking to get opportunities. Keaton trying to cut out here. Amang with a good control there. Cut out well there by Locko. And Lackey's now in chase. Hopefully this will get the Georgetown College defense up out of their back line now. Well controlled there by Castle. She's able to find Hackney comfortably. Hackney finds Miller. Miller's looking for that space right now. You can see right away she's looking for an opportunity there to screen forward. She does have it. She's got the speed on her, and she's forward now. This could be an opportunity here for Georgetown, but you see Martin Methodist, as soon as they see Libby Miller taking off into the final third, they are looking for an opportunity to cut her off. Three Martin Methodist defenders chase down into that corner, just cutting her off so she has no opportunity to get forward. Number 72, Kennedy here for Martin Methodist is your keeper this afternoon. Hackney controls, playing it forward there, looking for Lackey. And Locko's called for the foul there. Again, today is senior day. A lot of seniors here for the Georgetown College side as they're looking to hopefully pull off a big upset here, hopefully on their senior day, and can end it on a good note against the number 5 team in the nation here. Among flicks it forward here to Watari. Watari's here in the open space. Keaton and Chase. Kelsey Castle as well in Chase here, trying to cut her off here. trying to force her out to the left side. Watari's looking for that edge. They double team her well there. And it is going to go out of bounds here. It's going to be a goal kick. Well played there. So far in the beginning, we've had a couple moments where Watari and Yamasaki were able to get forward, but a couple minutes since then, they found opportunities to cut out that strong attack there from Martin Methodist. Martin with the big kick forward here. Looking for Van Lewitt. Cut out well there. Yeah, it's definitely going to be a high kick there. You know, last time we were together with a commentated match, it was against Shawnee State. And one of the things we'd mentioned in that match was is whether or not Georgetown was going to be able to counter well. And today's going to be one of those opportunities for them. Are they going to be able to counter well? Martin Methodist is going to throw a lot of numbers forward, trying to put as much pressure on that defense as they can. But today's going to be a good opportunity to get Van Lewitt, Sparks, and Libby Miller forward, hopefully looking for opportunities to get forward and score a couple goals in the counterattack when Methodist is pushing numbers forward today. It's going to be a throw in here for the Tigers, taken by Keaton. Keaton finds Gant. Quickly cut out there. Meg has it now. Meg's Castle there. It's well cut out there by Hilton. Excuse me, Vaught. Miller looking for Lackey. Lackey and Chase. Cut out well there by Casey. And there's Watari on the ball. She just does an incredible job of checking too and receiving it. You're going to see a lot of times where she's going to be there on that back line. She can do an immediate number nine check and then look for an opportunity to screen forward or find Yamasaki in a 1-2 combination. Yamasaki there finding Watari. Castle with a great job cutting that out. Gant looking to get forward now here. She finds Miller. And you can already see right there, Martin Methodist defense just giving her as much space. That way they just prevent any chance of her just screaming past them. Hackney with control, finds Castle. Castle drops to Martin. Keaton opens up. Well cut out there by Amel. Van Lewitt flicks. Miller battling. Hateen with the clearance. Finds Watari. Hackney with the well cut out there. Finds Castle. And Martin Methodist looking for a chance to counter. So far the center backs of Georgetown haven't been able to find any of our center defensive mids. And it's definitely caused a couple troublesomes here. And a good strike there by Watari. She's looking to just catch Meg off her line. Not going to score against an All-American keeper that easily. But, however, what we've seen so far in the beginning here, the Georgetown College defense not able to string together the passes they're looking for to be able to get forward, as it's been all Martin Methodist here in the early 10 minutes. Van Lewitt controls here. Finds Castle. Castle with quick pressure there. She's able to get that away. Well done from her. Vaught controls. Looking for Lackey. Lackey's cut off there. And it's cleared away there by Hateem. Looking for Abong. Well cut out here by Martin Methodist. They're screaming forward here. Finding Strobel. Strobel's not able to control. Strobel has it now. She is looking for Watari, and just like that, she's onside, and she screams it across the net. And it's going to go out as a goal kick, but you can just see how dynamic Yuki Watari is as she is just running back and forth across the Georgetown College back line, looking for an opportunity to screen forward. It's something that Lee is definitely going to have to address with her back line, whether it be someone just man-marking her or being able to drop back one of the center backs to just do some basic pressure cover there, because Yuki Watari's had plenty of opportunities here in the opening couple minutes. Can't be giving her more opportunities going forward. Otherwise, it's going to end up in a goal. Strobel controls here. Lackey with pressure trying to cut off Yamasaki. It is going to be a foul there on her and a free kick here. And they're looking to play quick, it looks like. Suzuzo Yamasaki here about to take this free kick. She is actually one of the nation's best players. In fact, this junior, when she was 17, was the U-17 national team captain for her home country, Japan. And since coming over to Martin Methodist, she's done nothing but do stellar, stellar performances, back-to-back-to-back, scoring goals and assists left and right. Talking to Will Austin when he was in the recruiting process of getting her, he said that she was just undeniably one of the best players he'd ever seen, and the improvement that she's made from her freshman to junior year is absolutely outstanding. So if Georgetown wants to have success today, they definitely have to find opportunities of shutting her down. Van Lewitt with the swing, it's intercepted there. Castle clears. Locko in chase, controlled there well by Hilton. Hilton drops, looking to cut off Among. Among's driving forward now. She cuts it back, cut off there by Hilton. Swung out wide, and Miller now has it. She's looking for an opportunity to get forward here with Tari with the cover. Locko looking to try and bring it down to prevent Among from getting a shot here. She is going to save it, though. Vaught trying to cut her off, so is Hilton. Blocked there by Hackney. Watari has it. A little miscommunication there between Amari and Among. And as we've seen so far, like we said in the beginning of this match, it's been all Martin Methodist screaming forward. However, Georgetown has done a good job of cutting out the two between them. Yamasaki and Watari haven't had a lot of combination plays getting forward, which is a good credit there to both Hilton and Hackney. If they've done a good job of just kind of anchoring in that defense. Hackney has it now. Looking for the big ball forward. Watari plays it out wide there. Good combination play there by Abong and Watari. Abong now has it. She's one-on-one here with Martin, and she slots it right by on the right side. Just simple 1-2 combination play there from Martin Methodist. As you saw, Watari just was able to get free. She found Abong, and Abong just kind of hung out there in the middle. Simple 1-2, played her right back, and it was a simple slot. No chance there from the keeper there, Martin, as it slid there on the right side. 1-0 here to the Red Hawks. That's something that Georgetown's going to have to be looking for, is Watari's already had multiple moments where she's just been able to scream forward, and so far there's been no answer from the Georgetown College offense, but hopefully Van Lewitt's big ball here getting Libby Miller forward is going to hopefully stem up something here that we can kind of grab onto to hopefully get a goal here. Keaton's going to take the throw. Finds Miller. Miller finding Van Lewitt. Van Lewitt with the cross there to Locko. Trying to find Lackey back, and it's cleared there well. Watari brings it down.
Throw in Tigers.
Strobel has it. Cleared out. Going to be Georgetown throw again. Keaton finds Miller, and it's going to be played out of bounds here. Fisk with the throw.
Throw in Tigers.
Keaton with the throw. Finds Gant. Gant's cut out there by Strobel. Keaton intercepts it right back. Well done there by Gant. She's looking to get forward here. And so far we can tell, number 12 there, Hatim, she is acting as a sweeper right now here for the back line, as she's just trying to cut out any chance of Libby Miller screaming forward. Martin Methodist knows the only chance here that Georgetown's had offensively going forward, which has kind of been their game plan all year, is just the counterattacks, and throwing Hatim back there to kind of play a sweeper set there has just prevented anything from Miller so far in the opening 15 minutes here. Yamasaki has it, looking for the big ball. Castle able to intercept well. Controlled by Glassman. Hackney has it. Van Lewitt controls. Finding Locko. Intercepted well there by Vaught. And cleared back right down to the throat of the Georgetown College defense. Keaton here got Strobel all over, looking for an opportunity to get it forward. Strobel's able to intercept and keep it for there on the Redhawks side. Swung in strong there. Watari's got an opportunity. Yamasaki now. It's cut off well. Well done there by the Georgetown College defense, just reeling there. But it's going to fall brilliantly there to Abong, and she just didn't seem to be ready for it. And Keaton was quick to her feet and was able to intercept. That could have been a dangerous situation there. It just looked like Abong was just not ready for that ball to just miraculously just kind of fall to her feet there. Keaton did an excellent job of recognizing it and being able to get forward there and prevent Abong from even having a shot. Van Lewitt controls here. She's cut out. Looking for the big ball there for Lackey. Lackey's definitely there chasing as well as Casey as they both chase down the ball. Casey looks to clear. Controlled by Lackey here. She finds Locko. Locko looking to put a cross in, and it's going to go out of bounds for a corner kick here for your Tigers. This could be a big opportunity here. We know multiple matches that the Tigers have played. They've been scoring on set pieces with Van Lewitt and Sparks, who Sparks isn't in the game just yet, but both of them have been brilliant in front of goal when it comes to just being able to out-muscle and out-win their defender and be able to hopefully head it into the back of the net here, looking for an opportunity to hopefully tie this match up back to 1-1. Hackney's corner came short. Headed back in there by Hilton. Hilton looking to cut her out here. It looks like it's going to be a counter here for Martin Methodist. Keaton reeling. She sees it. Strobel now in big attack as she's cut off here by Castle. Keaton just reeling, trying to cover in defense as well. Well cut out there. However, it's just opening up for an opportunity to swing out wide. Oof. So close as Martin was hugging the near post. And Fisk just screamed it for that far right post, looking for an opportunity to bounce that in, and it just goes well wide. But Martin was lucky there, just being hugging that front post. That goal was awfully looking big there for Fisk as she was looking for an opportunity to make this 2-0 towards the Redhawks. Looks like Martin Methodist trying to give a little medicine right back to the Tigers, trying to get some counter attacks in themselves. Watari heads it back in there. Hackney trying to clear. Gant follows. And Watari has it now. Fancy footwork there from Watari, finding Yamasaki. Van Lewitt chasing. Controlled there by Vasquez. Hatim plays it wide, looking for Fisk, and it's going to roll out of bounds here for Keaton to have a Georgetown College throw. Gant controls. Good turn there from her. She's cut out there by Vasquez. We've seen the Martin Methodist strikers do a good job of doing just little interplays between one another. Yamasaki driving forward now as Keaton's able to do a great job intercepting there. Libby Miller looking for an opportunity to get forward. Looking for space. She's able to find Keaton. Can Keaton get a – oof, so close there. If Keaton was able to get a touch, she would have had Millard running down the line as Vasquez was definitely gassed trying to chase her down. Strobel has it now. And Martin's going to collect easily. Big kick there from Martin. Well controlled there by Vasquez, and pretty flick there from Watari. Yamasaki now finding Strobel. Strobel's got an opportunity here. She's looking for that far corner, and again, the Redhawks so close. That far right part of that net is just wide open there. So close. Meg Martin was just hugging her near post and almost asking for him to give that far shot, but unfortunately, the Redhawks weren't able to score there. And fortunately for the Tigers, they didn't score. Martin looking for Van Lewitt. Van Lewitt with a good flick there. Keaton trying to cut off Strobel. Strobel gets forward. It's going to be a throw in for the Tigers. Gantz cut off. Watari now. Finding a bong. Castle there, right in her back, preventing any turn from there. Yamasaki now looking for Watari. Watari leaves it. Not sure if it was accidental or not, but Strobel was definitely looking for an opportunity to get a second chance at that far right shot. Watari controls here. Keaton just trying to stick her. Watari sees that Martin again is hugging that right side of that post, looking to see if she can get in that top left corner, but it's going to go wide. So far, like we said, it's just been all Redhawks here in the beginning, but hopefully the Tigers are going to be able to find opportunities getting forward. As you can see, Hatim there is just a lone sweeper there for the Redhawks. They are just screaming numbers forward. Hopefully the Tigers are going to be able to counterattack here and hopefully not this game back up 1-1. Yamasaki controls, finds Watari. It's cut off well there. Lackey clears, looking for Miller. Can Miller get a flick on it? Vital interception there from Fisk. Strobel screaming forward. Keaton now in chase. And that is going to go in this time. That one's going to slip under Meg Martin's arm, and it is now going to be 2-0. And Martin knows as she pats her chest there, knowing that that one slipped under her arm and she needed to save that. As it's now going to be 2-0 towards the Redhawks. As the Tigers here on opening for their senior day, not the way they wanted to start, that's for sure. But there's still hope, definitely, as we've been able to see so far. If Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks in multiple games this year, if they're able to find chances of screaming forward, then they're definitely going to find chances to score, and hopefully they can knot this game back up. Gant finds Miller. Miller trying to turn, and Fisk knows that her hands are full, marking up on her today. Fisk with the throw here. Recontrolled here by Hackney. Looking for Miller. Fisk is screaming forward, just preventing her from getting the ball. Gant sees an opportunity here for Miller to get forward, but Vasquez is well in cover. Seems every time that they're trying to find Libby Miller, the Redhawks know what the game plan is, and they're just cutting her off. Fisk has it. Watari now finds Yamasaki. Finding Watari again. Vaught trying to cut it off. Glassman looking for an opportunity to cross. It's going to go out of bounds here for a corner kick for the Redhawks. 25 minutes in here, and the Redhawks lead 2-0 over your Georgetown College Lady Tigers here on senior day. Tigers haven't even had a shot yet on goal. Hopefully, as the match continues, we can change that. Watari and Yamasaki talk. Beautiful cross round there. Looking for a bong. It's going to be a little too high there. Castle and chase. Throw in here for the Tigers, which is going to allow two subs to come in. Your two subs coming in right now are going to be Hunter Clark, number 17, and number 33, Maddie Sparks. Maddie Sparks actually is number 2 in the nation in game-winning goals and also is one of the leaders here on this team, tied with Libby Miller with 5 goals this season so far. Hopefully with the pairing between Maddie Sparks and Libby Miller, these two ladies are going to be able to find opportunities getting forward and hopefully be able to even this match up. Clark finds Miller. Miller finding Hackney. Hackney with a good turn there, trying to get forward. Yamasaki able to intercept easily. Looking for Lackey there. Finding Locko. Locko trying to turn the corner there. The outside back so far for Martin Methodist have done an excellent job preventing the speed that Georgetown has and not allowing them to get forward whatsoever. A bong now one-on-one with Martin, and she's able to just punch that right in as Castle just, I think there was a little bit of miscommunication there between Castle and Martin on who was going to come and get that ball, and unfortunately it looks like that's going to not home another goal here for the Redhawks as your Tigers trail 3-0 so far. Number 11, Mackenzie Strobel here, checking in for Watari. Hackney just looking to get the ball forward here into the opponent's half. And the team is there, and she clears it forward. Bong receives. Plays it out wide there to Glassman. Glassman screaming forward, looking for Strobel in the middle. She finds her. It goes right by. And the substitute right as she comes on. Her first touch there for Gabrielle Forsyth. Unfortunately, it's going to go right over the ball, right over the bar, as that was an opportunity there. Her first touch in the match could have been a goal. Tigers defense is going to have to become a little bit more compact here as they're looking for opportunities to get forward. If they're going to be able to hopefully bring this match back into a contention for a win or for a draw. Can't be allowing any more goals to get scored. So Tigers defense is going to have to come together and talk at halftime here to hopefully try and string back a comeback here in the second half. Martin trying to find Sparks. Vasquez cuts it off well. Castle screaming forward. And you can hear Leah Castleman on the sideline just cheering on our defense, telling her to come together, bring it together. We've still got time. Clark has it. Hackney there looking out wide. Good little 1-2 play there in the midfield and then played forward out there looking for Locko. It's just that final ball so far in this first half that just hasn't aided Georgetown at all, but they've found good opportunities playing 1-2s amongst another, but just that last ball hasn't been good enough to bring any type of offense or finish here. Martin collects easily, finding Keaton. Keaton finding Miller. Miller, good 1-2 there, looking for Keaton. Cut off there. Clark looking for Sparks. Sparks screaming forward now. Vasquez in chase. It is going to go out of bounds. You can see a team is just hanging out there in the back. You know, look at Will Austin's lineup here. He's got that sweeper back there for a reason because he's just trying to cut out as many counterattacks as he can so that Maddie Sparks and Libby Miller can't get forward using their speed and try and score. Clark drops it all the way back to Martin. Martin playing it wide here to Miller. Miller looking for an opportunity here to turn on Fisk. Fisk has done an excellent job so far in this first half, just preventing Libby Miller from any opportunity getting forward. I'm sure her coach had mentioned to her with the power in the offense that Libby Miller brings to the match, she's going to have her hands full, and she's handled her well today.
Another throw-in for the Tigers.
Throw-in for your Tigers here. Sparks has it. Big throw coming. Looking for Lackey. Well cut out there by Casey. Clark with the big throw, looking for Miller. Fisk intercepts. Hackney has it now. Looking out wide there. Hilton controls. Looking for Locko. Clark receives it back. Locko looking for the long ball, trying to play Lackey down the line. Well controlled there by Sparks. She's looking to turn on Vasquez, and she does. She's got Miller there in the middle. If she can find her, she finds her. Oh, it's bouncing around there. Oh, Lackey didn't have the opportunity to get forward. Well covered there by the Martin Methodist defense. That so far has been the best attacking option there, as Maddie Sparks has only been in here for about 5 minutes. Made a great turn there on Vasquez, looking for an opportunity to cross it into Miller, and she almost had it, just bounced around unfavorably there. Hackney has it. Strobel with the big ball looking. Vaught's able to intercept easily. Played out wide here by Methodist. Controlled by Vaught. She's looking for Sparks. And Vasquez is able to clear it back up the field. And Martin has it now. Looking for Miller and Fisk again. She's been there all day, just cutting out any chances there for Miller. Fisk has it. Coming down the left side. She crosses it. Castle's able to intercept there. Keaton covers. Finding Clark. A little bit more possession here out of the Tigers here to start out this last little half bit of the first half. Hopefully that slow start, though, hopefully it doesn't do them in and we can see some offense here from the Tigers. Martin plays the big ball forward, looking for Sparks. Vasquez is there on her back. Well controlled there by Sparks. So she's looking for Miller, looking for the big ball there. Unfortunately, since it wasn't over the top and on the ground, Fisk was able to control. But if that ball just would have been just a little bit higher to get over Fisk, Miller was definitely in the clear there. Yamasaki has it. Plays it out wide there to Glassman. Glassman controls, cutting inside. Trying to find Strobel. Strobel looking for the 1-2 for a bong, and she gave her the thumbs up. That 1-2 just wasn't there on that time. Well, controlled and compact there, a little bit better there from the Georgetown College defense as they were able to kind of just stay man-marked there and follow their man instead of following the ball. And Miller's going to scream over there to the left side, trying to get away from Fisk. She finds Sparks. Sparks plays the big ball to her forward, and there's a team. Again, that sweeper that's just sitting back there is just – that's exactly what she's there for. As soon as that long ball just kind of screams through there, she's just there to clear it and get it out. And so far, the Georgetown College offense just hasn't had any answers to it. Bang has it. Yamasaki looking for the big ball there. Castle shields, and Martin easily collects. Martin looking for Sparks. Fisk is there. Fisk has had an excellent game so far. Well controlled by Vasquez. She's looking for the big ball there to find Strobel. She does. Keaton, well done. Played from her. Castle finds it. Good header there to Keaton. Keaton, well controlled there by Sparks. Tigers have had a little bit more of the possession ever since Watari's gone out, and it's definitely helping out so far. Hackney easily to control, finds a good switch there. Hilton has it now. Well done, way to cut there. And unfortunately, it's that last ball that the Tigers just can't get forward. They've done a good job though on connecting passes here. Zabong's just screaming forward there as Castle's looking to cut her out. She makes a good move here, looking for Strobel. She's going to take the keeper one on one. And she slots it there in the back of the net, and it's going to be 4-0 there for the Redhawks as Martin was trying to cut off the angle. But unfortunately, Abong just too talented there. Got right around her and was able to find the high posted shot. It's your Tigers trail here 4-0 with 10 minutes left here in the first half. Miss Lizzie Brigmore is going to check in here for Hackney. The slow start for the Tigers definitely doing them in here, as those first 10 minutes was just all Martin Methodist, and unfortunately the Tigers just haven't really had any answers here. Yamasaki shoving sparks off the ball. Rouse throws. Finding Brady. Brady has it. Yamasaki lets it run by. Controlled here by Methodist as they're looking for an opportunity to get forward. Martin comes up with the save there.
Shot number 11, Gabriel forces save, Megan Martin.
Martin finding Keaton out wide. Brigmore with a good check. And she's tripped up there. I mean, these last 10 minutes have been good possession here for the Tigers. However, it just hasn't resulted in a goal, and unfortunately did result in a goal there on the counterattack there for the Redhawks. So hopefully the Tigers can put in one goal maybe before halftime and maybe kind of turn this tide just a little bit. Come out second half, come out strong, come out fast, maybe put in another and make this game a little bit more interesting. Clark controls, finding out wide to Keaton. Keaton has it now. Finding Prigmore. Prigmore drops to Clark. Clark looking. That was a good opportunity there, getting forward. Sparks, I don't think, was ready for it. Vasquez cut it out. Controlled by the Redhawks. Yamasaki getting forward there. And Keaton's just going to let that roll back there to Martin. Adisa Among has been the issue here for the Tigers today, as she's been able to net home three goals, giving herself a hat trick. Hasn't been Watari and Yamasaki that's caused any issues. It's really been her. She's just done a great job of checking in to the midfield, receiving the ball, finding good opportunities forward. And when she does have it, she's been a clinical finisher so far, as every shot she's had other than one has resulted in a goal so far. Keaton shoved out of the way there by Brady. The two battle there in the corner, and Keaton's able to come up with it. Not the senior day start the Tigers were looking for today. We've got about 6 minutes left here in the first half as they trail 4-0 to the Redhawks. Controlled by Vaught. Keaton has it now. A little bit of a formation change here by the Tigers, as Libby Miller's going to head up top as the lone striker, and Maddie Sparks is going to sit underneath her as a 9-10 duo here. Yamasaki controls. Plays the big ball, and Martin's easily able to collect. Martin with the beautiful kick forward, cut out there by Vasquez. Brigmore has it with a good turn here. She's able to find Lackey. And Kitty Lackey and Maddie Sparks just not on the same page there, as Lackey tried to play her down the line and Maddie was cutting inside.
Goalkeeper change for Martin Methodist is number 1, Brooke Shavers, as well as number 18, Grace
Gray Sanchez going to replace Yamasaki. And Brooke Shaver is going to replace Gabby Kennedy to be the new keeper. Brady cut out there by Keaton. Sparks and Brady now battling. Brigmore with a big kick forward there. Hatim's there to clear it. Finding Rouse. Brigmore finds Clark. Clark's closed down well there, but she's able to find Vaught easily. It's been all Georgetown here the last 10 minutes controlling the ball. Just haven't been able to find opportunities to score. Keaton looking for Sparks. Hatim there screaming forward. Well cut out by Vaught. Brigmore has it. She's cut out there by Gabrielle. Gabrielle screaming forward now. She's 5-on-1. Clark does a good job cutting her out there. Sparks with the turn. Sparks now trying to get forward. If she can find Miller here, they could be off and running. And just a vital, you could just see, just a vital tackle there from Sarah Casey. She just did not want Libby Miller getting behind her because she knows as soon as Libby Miller gets behind on the defense, she's definitely looking for an opportunity there on net. Throw in Tigers. Played out by Casey. Vaught collects. Finds Sparks. Sparks flicks it over the top here. Trying to find Prigmore there, and it's cleared out there by Martin Methodist. The Methodist defense reeling here just a little bit here at the end of this first half. We might see a goal here from the Tigers, which would be fantastic to see to make it 4-1 heading into halftime. Trying to spark a counter. Prigmore then slides it beautifully to Lackey. Lackey, oh, and no one was in the box, unfortunately, as she was just looking to play a ball there in the box, trying to find Sparks or Miller as Lackey and them just not on the same page. Clark controls easily. Finds Keaton. Keaton finds Castle. Castle's happy to just play back there to Martin. Swings it out wide to Vaught.
Throw in Tigers.
And looking to find Miller. And she's as soon as she's running back there, you can already tell all that Martin Methodist defense is dropping back. It's going to earn a throw in here, and Prigmore's got it. Was trying to find Hilton there, and she lost it. Castle has it now. In chase is Brady for Martin Methodist. Martin Conley finds Keaton. Lackey looking to cut her off. Well done. Cuts off Gabrielle well there. It's going to be a free kick here for the Tigers. Lizzie Prigmore, sophomore midfielder, is going to take the free kick here. It's going to be a free kick here as Miller's fouled there just outside the box. One combination offensively we haven't seen yet today is Maggie Van Lewitt there with Sparks and Libby Miller. Unfortunately, three of them haven't been in the match together. Hopefully, Leah Castleman will throw them in together, and hopefully we can see those three dynamic duos as they combine for over 80% of the goals here for this team, as together they hopefully are going to be able to find a chance here to score and bring this game back into competition. Is Brinkmore looking to catch the keeper, just not looking, but unfortunately the substitute there, Brooke Shavers, is ready for it. We wind down here in the last 10 seconds here. As we've seen so far, it has just been all Martin Methodist. They've just been finding endless opportunities forward and able to score and get forward, and it's just allowed for a 4-0 halftime lead as the number 5 team in the country coming in here on Senior Day leads your Georgetown College Lady Tigers 4-0. Hopefully in the second half we're going to be able to see a dynamic trio between Maggie Van Lewitt, Maddie Sparks, and hopefully Libby Miller, and the three of them will be able to come together and possibly net just a couple goals and maybe bring this game back into serious contention. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have about 15 minutes here before the start of the second half. And before we let you all just head off now into halftime, just want to say, hey, Tiger fans, do you have a favorite GC sports team or academic department? Are you a Tiger mate? Or on GC Giving Day, Tuesday, March 16th, you all can double the impact and your gift by supporting the areas of Georgetown College that mean most to you. Visit gogc.me/givingday to learn more about our fun challenges and how you can make and take one moment on Tuesday, March 16th to make a difference in the lives of the current and future Tigers. Thank you for your support, and go Tigers. Ladies and gentlemen, we're heading into halftime here. We'll see you all here in about 15 minutes as the Redhawks lead your Tigers 4-0.
Hello to all my good friends who might be watching or listening. This is John, or Doc Blackburn, again. 3 years ago, I made a giving challenge, which was very successful, thanks to you all, and have done it each of the past 2 years as well. Today, I'm making my fourth challenge, and I wanted to say a little bit about why I do this. I'm in the process of doing my taxes for last year, and that entails looking at my income and expenses for the year. It occurs to me that I am a microcosm of Georgetown College as far as finances go. It doesn't really matter how much I have at the moment. I must have a certain annual income to function each year. The college is like that, and the blood of the annual income that allows the college to function the way we want to function is the annual fund. Each year, to pay my expenses, I rely on my income for the year. It's so with the college. The annual fund pays the bills and must be accrued every year for that purpose. This is why I'm again issuing my challenge. I will match your donations that come to the college by the annual day of giving, Tuesday, March 16th, up to a total of $25,000 for the annual fund. That way, you and I can account for at least $50,000 of that fund and possibly much more, as has happened in the past 3 years. I'm proud and humbled by your response and fast, and hope that you will again rise to the occasion. Thanks so much for your participation. Call and challenge your friends. Thank you.
Here's how this will work. You'll watch this commercial, then look up Georgetown College. No, not that one, a Christian college in Kentucky. You'll be impressed with the school and your scholarship. You'll watch GC win yet another national championship with lifelong friends. You'll attend Oxford University. You'll take a class with that professor who blows your mind. You'll find your major and your career. You'll get internships and graduate, and your Georgetown degree will get you that first job or into grad school. You'll remember this as the moment that shaped your life. You're welcome. Think different. Think GC. Apply now at georgetowncollege.edu.
It's not about classes just being harder. It's always about depth in a subject matter.
We take all the excellent work that you've already done as a student, wherever you are, and then we supercharge it. We send you off to Oxford University, where you work one-on-one with an Oxford professor. You come back with an entire worldview.
What Georgetown College does exceptionally well is it gives students the opportunity to have an extraordinary research experience either here or any place else in the country.
Last summer, I got to participate in research at Marshall University. and it was a super cool experience.
This is like the main research I've done in college, and this is pretty much what's gonna get me to grad school.
One of my favorite things about the honors program is that it really does feel like a family. You just have these bonds with each other that are unbreakable.
Part of that care for you, however, is to try to urge you towards the highest skills and virtues that you've got to offer.
Let's talk numbers. One, that's our ranking in Kentucky for the difference we make in our students' future earnings. Three, that's the number of years in a row we've been ranked as best in Kentucky for students getting their first job or into graduate school. 100, that's the percentage of fully qualified students from our pre-med program who get accepted into medical school. 30, that's the number of seconds it just took to change your life. Think different. Think GC. Apply for free at georgetowncollege.edu.
I wanted to make sure I went to a college that could help me grow in my faith. Georgetown just encourages me.
I've just learned to accept that we have different beliefs and we may believe different things within Christianity, but we all come together.
When I came here and got to know the staff and faculty,
I just felt like it was very personal.
Ever since I've been here, I have grown closer to God. It has allowed me to grow further in my faith.
When I was looking at Georgetown College, I found that they had a Christian scholars program that kind of focused on vocation and a person's calling.
Two things that have made it incredibly important about its history is its commitment to academics and its commitment to be faith-filled and help nurture this Christian identity.
The way they see their role in the world is greatly transformed from being a Christian to doing something as Christ would do for the world around them.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here to Georgetown College as we get ready here for the second half between your Georgetown College Lady Tigers and the Martin Methodist Red Hawks. And like we saw there in the beginning, the number five team of the nation didn't disappoint. The first 15 minutes, they were able to slot home three goals right away. This Martin Methodist offense is led by two very high-powered Japanese nationals, as we were able to see them take over. Yamasaki and Watari were able to lead. However, it was one in particular, Adisa Among. In fact, she was the one who netted home three goals in the first half to give her Martin Methodist Redhawks an early lead, and it has been all Martin Methodist since the whistle. Hopefully, as the Tigers come out here to start this second half, Leah Castman's made some adjustments here on senior day to allow them an opportunity to hopefully just slot home a couple goals and maybe even make this game a little interesting here towards the end. And we do have a sub, though, here for the Tigers, as we've got a couple new players that have checked into today's match. One in particular is the one that is in the net. Casey Zimmerman was able to replace their Megan Martin. Megan Martin had a couple of couple injuries here left and right from sliding on the turf there. So she's going to go ahead and just call it for the rest of today's match, and they're going to go ahead and hand it over there to the sophomore, Casey Zimmerman, who has started one game this year. She's 1-0. And the second half kickoff has begun here. Controlled there by Vaught. A little miscommunication there as number 18, Megan Abney, checks into today's match. Controlled there by Strobel. Hackney intercepts. Hackney looking down the line there for Lackey. Lackey now screaming forward. And Lily Fisk, the left back there for Martin Methodist, has had just an excellent match as she's been able to shut down her side, not allowing any opportunities. Watari dances on it, looking to get forward. Well cut out there by Armstrong. Armstrong here with the throw for the Tigers. And Watari's tripped up there by Hackney. You know, we talked in the beginning for the day's match. We thought Watari and Yamasaki were going to be the two that were really going to be taking over. But it's really been a bong. She's just had plenty of opportunities getting forward there. Number 10 for Martin Methodist is every time she's able to receive it and turn, she's just had plenty of green space, and that's allowed her getting forward. A team now looking for her, but Castle's able to intercept there. Deflects backwards there. Well controlled by Armstrong. But we just haven't seen any opportunities there for the Tigers there in the first half, as they were only able to net one shot off target. But other than that, nothing on goal so far. So hopefully this second half we can see that high-powered offense we've seen in multiple games this season hopefully get forward. Well controlled there by Vaught, finding Hackney. Hackney now looking forward, trying to find Gant. Gant able to deflect it back from a team. Vasquez clears it off the line. Controlled by Gant. She finds Kelsey Castle there. Castle, one of the seniors recognized today. Today's her senior day. And unfortunately played an errant ball there that's going to go out of bounds. Good pressure there from the two duo strikers there, Nabong and Strobel. Yamasaki with some fancy footwork there. And controlled there up to Lackey. Bong receives, plays it back there well. Finding Yamasaki. Who's looking for a Bong, who she's screaming forward. And first touch there for Casey Zimmerman. She just calmly collects. Big kick there from Zimmerman, finding Gant, who controls well. Finding Van Lewitt, who's cut out there by Matari. Watari in chase there on Van Lewitt. Finds Lacko. Lacko not able to turn, finds Ngabong. Hopefully it looks like the Martin Methodist offense there trying to scream here for a counterattack. Tigers defense reeling here, trying to just cut out whatever they can. Well controlled there by Vaught to get it cleared. The runs that the attacking offense there from Martin Methodist make is really dynamic. Hopefully we can see the Tigers make some similar runs here in this second half. Hopefully net home a couple goals, make this game interesting. Hackney finds it. She's cut out. She's able to find Armstrong well. Gant has it. Gant with the fancy footwork there. A little step over. A little cutback. Hackney has it. Hackney telling her team, please scream forward, as she was just dribbling there in no man's land and just couldn't find anybody. Strobel looking for an opportunity to scream forward, and now she is. She's cutting in towards goal right now. She's one-on-one here with Casey Zimmerman. Zimmerman with the great right leg save there. Kicks it out of Bong now looking for her fourth goal. She's not able to get it. Great one-on-one save there from Casey Zimmerman, as she's checked in today's match and already knotted home her first save in the first 5 minutes. Watari's cut out there from Castle. Hackney with a brilliant ball there for Van Lewitt, but that sweeper set there by Hatim. Hatim is literally, that is her whole entire job. Just sit there on that back line and clear any long balls that could possibly be coming forward. And unfortunately, looks like Will Austin's definitely done his homework there on the Georgetown College offense of just trying to find that long ball and the speed and the pace for dynamic Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks and Maggie Van Lewitt, and him putting Hatim back there has just cut out any opportunities. Kelsey Castle with the great tackle there. She's able to find Vaught. Vaught's trying to find Van Lewitt. Van Lewitt trying to flick, and Vasquez is going to deflect it out of bounds here, and the Tigers are getting forward. Locko will throw. Locko has it. Vasquez with the clear. Once again, a throw in for the Tigers. Locko looking there for Lackey. Not able to find it. Hatim with the costly mistake there. Lackey, there was just no one in the middle, as she just kind of just played that ball across as the team was desperate in chase trying to cut her off. Unfortunately, no one was there in the middle, and now it looks like Watari is screaming forward here. 3-on-2 there. Bong now has it. She's looking for Strobel out wide. She doesn't find her, but she does find Watari right back, and Armstrong with just the diving slide tackle trying to prevent anything from coming through. Watari with the fancy footwork isn't able to get through, and it's going to be cleared out there by the back line for the Tigers. Vasquez putting it back in, looking for Fisk. Finds her. Fisk looking for the 1-2 on Watari. Watari turns. She's able to find Yamasaki, cut out there well by Castle. Glassman has it now. Looking for a good ball there to Strobel. She finds her. Strobel with the beautiful cross there. Cut off well by Vaught. Vaught's able to intercept and now looking for an opportunity to get forward. Well done from her. Good calm play there from Vaught. Find Locko calmly just plays it right back to her. These two ladies are doing a good job here just keeping that ball together. And Vaught's going to go ahead and clear her lines. Van Lewitt with a good switch there to Gant. Watari intercepts. Good cut out there by Hilton. Hilton now looking to get forward. And well saved there by Casey Zimmerman. Could have been another goal there, but luckily she was ready to go. Throw in here. Glassman finding Watari. Watari trying to turn here. Finding Vasquez. Finds Fisk. And Martha Methodist is able to keep possession here. Intercepted by Vaught. Talking to Coach Will Austin here for the Martin Methodist Redhawks for today's match. He had mentioned to me that Yamasaki is one of the most versatile players that he's ever coached. He said that her growth from freshman year to junior year has been one of incredible stature. She's definitely looking to win NAIA Player of the Year, number 8 there on top of the ball. She's looking for opportunities to get forward every day. And in fact, there have been incredible opportunities for her already in today's match. She's just done a great job facilitating there in the midfield and finding her teammates, and it's allowed for Adisa Among to have the 3 goals she's netted so far. Trying to catch out Casey Zimmerman there. And it's going to scream well wide over the net. Number 17, Hunter Clark's going to check in today's match. Placing there, number 22, Jalen Vaught. Zimmerman plays it forward. It's going to be offside there. First offside call all day today. Good play there from Hackney to find Gant. Gant now looking to get forward. Clark has it. Clark looking for Locko. Glassman does a great job intercepting there. It's going to throw in for the Tigers. Both Hunter Clark and Maddie Sparks both have long throws. You see there, she threw it from the 43 and was able to land over to the 20. It's a fantastic throw there from Hunter Clark. Good stand-up job there. Well done from Lizzie Armstrong. However, the ball does leak through, and Abong is now one-on-one here with Kelsey Castle. She's looking to get by. Fancy footwork here, opening up the mid. And Abong's just running through, looking for a call. Not going to get it. Official not falling for the dive on that one. Vasquez heads. Lackey and Chase. Watari and Hackney battling there. Hackney plays it long, looking for Locko. She finds her.
Throw in for the Red Hawks.
Red Hawks lead here 4-0. Almost a quarter way through here on this second half here. So far, it's just been all Red Hawks. But hopefully the Tigers are able to string one together here. As far as the second half is concerned, it's still 0-0 for the second half for the Tigers. Gant's now screaming forward. She's looking to catch the keeper off her line, and she does. A fantastic shot there. Braylon Gant with the goal. Fantastic, as she was able to see that the keeper was off of her line there, and Brooke Shavers, I don't think, was anticipating the shot to be coming in, and Braylon Gant saw the opportunity, played a beautiful shot that just dipped right over and under that crossbar and over the keeper's hands, and that's going to make it 4-1 here, and we had mentioned there at the end of the first half that if the Tigers were able to just get one goal possibly, maybe they can string together a comeback here, but so far we don't see Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks warming up to come back in. Wonder if Leah's just saving them for a little bit later. Hopefully we'll see them check back in here in just a little bit, but that is the right way to start the second half as the Tigers make it 4-1 here against the number 5 team in the nation. Fantastic job there by Braylon Gant as it's now 4-1. Yamasaki plays the long ball there. And a bonk's fouled there. Tigers did a good job. Little counterattack there and was able to swing it out wide. And Braylon Gant was able to have a beautiful shot. Not sure if she was shooting or crossing, but to be honest with you, we don't care. It's a goal. So it's going to be 4-1 now as the Red Hawks lead your Tigers. the Japanese dynamic duo here on the ball. You can see this one's been drawn up, and luckily it does sneak through, and it's going to end up a goal kick. Looks like the training pitch was used there for that one, but Tigers seem to be ready for it. Watari was able to find it there. Finding Yamasaki. It's intercepted. And headed away by the sub there, Nicole Alec. Casey Zimmerman playing the long ball, looking for Maggie Van Lewitt. Vasquez in chase. Hateen clears. Clark flicks it back there. Finds Lackey. Vasquez clears. Handball from the Tigers. It's going to be a free kick here for the Red Hawks. The team here with the free kick. She's looking for Watari. Anna Bong. Good battle there. Armstrong wins that. And the team's just going to throw it right back down. Great play from Kelsey Castle. She comes screaming forward and heads that ball. Looked to be about 30 yards up in the air. Well done from her. Clark has it. Finds the center midfield perfectly. Van Lewitt now. Van Lewitt's one-on-one. And just couldn't control it, and the team was able to intercept. That was good build-up play there from the Tigers. Great start to the second half here for the Tigers. You know, when you're down 4-0, it's hard to kind of come together and say, let's do this. But so far, these seniors aren't giving up, and they definitely just edged on their team to hopefully just be able to strike back a comeback. They score one more goal, and it's 4-2. It's going to be a little bit more interesting here as Will Austin might have to start reconsidering kind of what he's doing here for the Red Hawks offense and Leah Castleman. Hopefully she just encourages her team to try and slot some more goals home, make this game even more interesting than it is. Glassman has it. Finds Watari. Watari finds her right back. Quick 1-2 there. Watari has it now. Fancy footwork there. Lackey looking to intercept. Good cut out there by Kelsey Castle. She's had an excellent start to the second half. Van Lewitt has it. Locko has it. Locko trying to get the 1-2, well intercepted there by Glassman. Glassman looking to play on a bong. She does. Castle now in chase. They're going to double team here. She's looking for the fancy footwork, looking for an opportunity to get in. Good job there from Ms. Zimmerman as she comes out and collects that ball to prevent a bong from getting another shot on frame. Cut out there by Casey. Throw in here for the Tigers. Intercepted there by Casey. And it looks like number 13 here for the Tigers is able to collect. Yuli Spade. Freshman checking in here. Excuse me, sophomore checking in here. Well controlled there by Armstrong as she finds the freshman Nicole Alec. Casey has it now. Clark has it. Finds Alec. Drops it back to Castle. Castle back to Zimmerman. Zimmerman just looking to clear her lines. Finds Locko. Locko knees it forward. Well done there. Not able to find the 1-2 connection there, but Locko's able to fight back. Cuts it off well there. Able to save it. Looking for Lackey as Lackey's chasing down Casey there. Able to force over the turnovers. Nicole Alec screaming forward. She's got Gant there on the right side. Doesn't see her, though. Alec there with the desperate save to keep that ball. And unfortunately, Yuli's ball is just going to be a little short there, and it's intercepted there by Glassman. Locko has it. Finds Clark. Watari and Chase. Castle has it now. Finds Zimmerman. Looking for the long ball there to... Doesn't find it. Clark has it now. Collects. Nicole Alec looking to cut her off there. Yamasaki plays a long ball down there to Abong. Good job from Casey Zimmerman coming off her line there to collect that ball just to prevent any chances there. And Yamasaki's tripped up there by the freshman. Free kick here for the Redhawks. Watari unable to control. Kelsey Castle intercepts. Van Lewitt now brings it down. Looking for speed. Looking for an opportunity to counter here. Yuli has it. Yuli looking out wide to Locko. I don't think Locko was ready for that as Glassman was quick to retreat there to cut that off. It's going to be a throw in there for the Redhawks. Throw in here for the Redhawks. Control there by Casey. Casey plays long ball forward there. Yuli able to intercept. Well done from her. Finds Clark. Clark trying to beat the double team there, but Watari was ready for it and intercepted. Drop back to a team. A team plays long ball forward. Looking for Yamasaki. It's intercepted there by Alec. Yamasaki with the big ball forward. Locko in retreat. Watari's free here. Well cut out there by Armstrong. She did a great job in pressure cover, coming back and preventing Watari from possibly trying to slot home a goal. Yamasaki with the quick corner there. Georgetown wasn't ready as Watari's just got freedom to do what she wants. As she finds Yamasaki right back, who's going to put it in the box there. Well defended there by Alec. Van Lewitt now in chase. Finds Lackey. Lackey's intercepted. Castle trying to get the vital clearance. Well done from Zimmerman. She saves it off the line. Well done from Casey Zimmerman. Watari working over there. She finds Bong. Bong trying to turn on her right. She turns on Castle. She's able to. Georgetown College defense was just desperate to prevent any shot from coming in. Locko's able to finally clear the lines. And freshman number 4, Cleo Wells, checks into today's match. Number 10, Haven Locko. Atari intercepted there. Finds Van Lewitt. Van Lewitt was looking to turn. Atari tripped up there. Yuli all over. Castle, great job intercepting there. Trying to find Van Lewitt, and it deflected off her back and right in front of her face. It's odd. I haven't seen that before. Clark takes the throw, looking for Lackey. Vasquez in chase. Hatim's there to clear. It's kind of been the story there for the Martin Methodist defense. All they've done is just allowed a long ball to go through, and Hatim's right there to clear it right back up the field. Van Lewitt with the flick, looking for Lackey. Vasquez does a good job of intercepting, but it does deflect backwards here just a little bit. A little miscommunication between her and the team, and Lackey was able to intercept and kind of get a deflection there. But it's recontrolled there by the Redhawks. Castle finds Van Lewitt. Van Lewitt with a beautiful turn there on Vasquez. Excuse me, on Casey. Looking for the freshman, and unfortunately Wells just couldn't get there. Good interception there from Hatim. She knew what was coming and was able to intercept it there. She's getting forward now. Tried to find Watari. Good interception by Clark. And Hilton just wasn't able to control. And here comes that high-powered offense back onto the field as number 26, Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks check into today's match. Van Lewitt and Lackey are going to check out. Hopefully these next 20 minutes can result in the two of them getting forward as that back line for Martin Methodist looks just a little bit tired there as the team's got her arms there on her waist. Hopefully the Tigers can get forward and get Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks in good positions. Watari finds a gap there in the back line as she screams forward. Nicole Alley, great job covering there for her center back. McNeil has it, looking for a cross. Castle finds it, clears it. Kamiti tried to put it back there in the box, and it's cleared where there by Armstrong. Vasquez puts it back in, looking for Watari. Armstrong's there. Yamasaki intercepts, finds Watari. Yamasaki now wide open there in the middle as they're reeling there. Watari has it, drops it back. Clark has it. Able to find the freshman Wells, who unfortunately just lets it go right on her feet. Libby Miller was able to come and chase, and now she's got it now, looking for an opportunity to get forward here. Cut out well there by Kamiti. Cleared there by Casey. Sparks has it. Casey cuts off Libby Miller well there. Hatim now. Trying to clear her lines. Cut out there by Wells. Good pressure here by the back line. Excuse me, on the back line by the Georgetown College offense. Substitutes have brought a little life out here as it's 4-1 with 20 minutes remaining almost. Yamasaki plays it long. Looking for Watari. She definitely has the speed there on Castle, but luckily Castle's trying to cut down that angle. Armstrong's there in coverage there in the middle. Castle's desperate to control there. Well done by Hilton. Screaming forward, though. And well defended and controlled there by Nicole Alleg. Nicole Alleg's done a great job getting back as a center defensive mid, just able to cut off any attack there. She's done a good job checking in. Impressive there from a freshman. Casey Zimmerman here with the goal kick. Yamasaki controls. Clark there in chase. Clark has it. Hilton. Hilton. and Hilton's able to prevent the cross, but it is going to be here for a corner kick for the Redhawks. You know, now that Libby Miller and Maddie Sparks are in the match here in the second half, they've gotten plenty of rest. Hopefully the Tigers are able to get forward and find those two. Maybe slot home a second goal, make it 4-2, and put that pressure on the Redhawks to try and finish out today's match. Watari saves it. He's looking for the far post. It's cut off well. Well done from Armstrong clearing that off the line. Armstrong intercepts. She intercepts again. Castle now. And with the big ball forward, looking for Miller. Casey quick there to control. Wells looking for it. And Watari screaming down the sideline here. Is she able to save it? She does. And it's going to be a throw in there for the Redhawks. Watari drops it back there to Caminti. It's looking for a cross. Well controlled there by Alec. Clark didn't know that Watari is right behind her. Now Watari trying to dice up the back line, trying to look for an opportunity. Yamasaki the same. She's getting tripped up there. And well defended there by the defense of the Tigers, just doubling her. Castle finding Yuli. Clark finding Wells. Sparks now has it. And story of the day there for the back line. Hatim intercepts, sends it right back down to the front of the Georgetown College defense, and she's done a great job of just intercepting any long ball chances. Alec looking for somebody. Hilton has it, playing the long ball forward, looking for Miller. Casey's able to deflect it out. Miller has it, looking to turn. She's got space, trying to get around Hatim. Unfortunately, it's going to go out of bounds, but that just shows you right there, as soon as Miller's able to turn, she's got the speed. If she's got the space, there is an opportunity for her to get forward. However, her team's just done a good job today of just being back there on that back line, preventing any counterattacks, which has really just been the story of today's game. You know, in the first half, the Redhawks just came out a little bit faster than the Tigers did, and unfortunately resulted in three early goals, and then the Tigers were kind of reeling from there. Her team has just kind of sat back in the back. I know her manager, Will Austin, has definitely just been telling her to just sit back there and prevent any counterattacks from Maddie Sparks or from Livy Miller, but just hasn't allowed any opportunities for the Tigers of getting forward. And Maddie Sparks is still down here. She was tackled hard. We just hope she's okay with Libby Miller standing over her. Maddie Sparks, losing her would be really, really tough on this Georgetown team, as she is not at home 5 goals and 1 assist this year, and she's tied as one of the leading scorers there for the Tigers, tied there with her partner in crime, Libby Miller, who's just kind of standing there next to her, hoping everything's okay. And for the Tigers, number 20, Taylor Feldman, a sophomore, midfielder checking into the match, as well as Kitty Lackey's going to be replacing Maddie Sparks, who's unfortunately hobbling off now. Our prayers and thoughts are going to be with her, as that'd be a massive loss for the Tigers, not just for the match. 12 minutes left. The match isn't the problem. It's if we lose Maddie Sparks for the rest of the season, which we're all praying and hoping. I know that she's got an ankle brace on there. She's had multiple ankle injuries. Lord willing, she's going to be okay and be able to get forward as we're gearing towards the end of the season, hoping to look for a good seed here in the Mid-South Conference Tournament. They're definitely going to need her. Castle plays it out wide. Hilton controls. Miscommunication there between her and Wells, it looked like. Caminti holding on to it for too long as Wells is able to fight. Casey comes screaming through and plays it out. Clark swings it wide to Armstrong. Armstrong plays out wide there to Natalie Harris, a freshman. And here comes a one-on-one attack, and Kelsey Castle unfortunately dove in there for the quick little move that Brady made, and unfortunately it's going to be a penalty kick here taken for the Redhawks. As no, Kelsey Castle's just kind of got some heavy legs as she's been playing all day today, and unfortunately the senior drew a penalty there, and it was an easy call there for the official, and looks like Yamasaki's going to try and net this one home to make it a 5-1 score line in favor of the Redhawks. Casey Zimmerman, the sophomore goalkeeper, in goal. And she slots it there to the right side of the keeper, left side for your viewing, and it's going to be 5-1 in favor here of the Redhawks with about 11 minutes left in today's match. First penalty drawn today, but there have been plenty of opportunities where the Redhawk offense has been screaming forward, looking for opportunities to score, and looks like that's going to be the day there for Miss Yamasaki. Tigers find Clark out wide, finds Hilton. Hilton screaming forward now. Cut out there by Casey. Kelsey Castle playing it back to her keeper Zimmerman. Alec has it now. Finds Hilton. Hilton looking for Wells. Intercepted there by Kamini. Armstrong's intercepted there by Brady. Throw in taken here by Natalie Harris. Trying to find Miller, and she does. But Casey has been on Miller's back since the moment that Miller's checked into the match, and Miller's just had no chances getting forward. And Casey, again, there, beats her to the ball. She's just trying to prevent any chances of Libby Miller being able to screen forward and not home a goal. Gabrielle has it. Intercepted there well by Armstrong. Meany trying to save it, and she does. She plays it down the line, and Hilton's hopefully going to shield and let that go out. Throw in here for the Tigers. Castle finding Hilton. Hilton trying to find Wells. She does. Hill's will just trying to clear the lines. Intercepted well there by Armstrong. Finds Lackey. Lackey, also one of the seniors here on the Georgetown College team. She's just looking to finish out. He's the last 8 minutes here on her field. Alec finds Clark. Unfortunately, just a little too long there. Brady has it. Brady and Armstrong battling there in the corner. Well done by Armstrong. She's, ever since she's checked into the game, that right back there, number 23, Armstrong, she's done a really good job of just cutting off her side, preventing any goals from coming from her side. In fact, massive improvement on both sides defensively on the right and left side there for the Tigers. They've only allowed one goal here in the second half. Unfortunately, that slow start in the beginning has done the Tigers in. Armstrong looking to clear lines. Casey Zimmerman sliding out. And Wells is fouled. Last 7 minutes here for your Tigers. Hopefully they can make this a 5-2, 5-3 scoreline. Try and not home two goals before the end of the match. Kelsey Castle seemed to, not sure if she got hurt or just tripped up there, kind of buckled her knee, but as soon as she tried to make a turn there and prevent that ball from getting across, she kind of buckled her knee there and stopped for a little bit, which allowed Brady to get through, but well covered there by Zimmerman. Played ahead there by Zimmerman. Looking for Wells. Looks like it's going to leak out of bounds there. Nope. Save there. Excuse me. Hilton shielding. Just going to let that ride. Castle clears, looking for Miller. And defended there by Kamini. Wells looking for Miller, who's double teamed there. Throw in there by Clark, looking for Lackey. She's cut off there by Vasquez. Going to be a goal kick here for the Red Hawks. Gabby Kennedy here with the, excuse me, Brooke Shavers here with the goal kick. And Kitty Lackey's going to hit that out of bounds. Going to be a goal kick again here for the Red Hawks. On a good note, I do see Maddie Sparks walking around down there on the sideline, so it looks like she is moving, which is good to hear. So hopefully after a couple treatment, maybe even an ice bath after today's match, she'll be good to go for the upcoming matches starting this week. Brooke Shavers clears the lines. Well controlled there by Alec. Well done to head it just right back there. Collected by keeper number one, Brooke Shavers. Unfortunately, the offense just hasn't been there for the Tigers, and unfortunately the defense wasn't either, as the Redhawks, the number 5 team in the nation, undefeated, came in here with a mission to spoil senior day. And with a 5-1 scoreline, I'd say they've definitely done that. This is going to be an opportunity, though, for the Tigers to grow and to learn, hopefully. Hopefully be able to learn from this and become a better team after it. After the most recent loss against Lindsey Wilson. The one before that, they went on a 3-game winning streak. So hopefully after this one, they'll be able to string a couple wins together and possibly find opportunities to climb back up in the rankings of the NAIA Mid-South Conference. Hilton has it, finds Castle. Castle looking for Armstrong. Finds Clark. Finds Alec. Clark, good job intercepting Brady there. Armstrong looking for the long ball there to Lackey. Vasquez is there to cut it off. Kind of been the story of the day, if we've mentioned multiple times today, is just unfortunately the Georgetown College offense with the long ball game. Will Austin and his team were well prepared, had a good game plan as a team. Casey and Vasquez and even Fisk all sat back there strong today and were preventing any counters from happening whatsoever. Gabrielle now. Tigers intercept. Well done by Hilton to control and find Wells. Wells now looking for Miller. As Miller's trying to screen forward, as this has kind of been her first opportunity there in open space, as she's able to control the ball with Kamini right there behind her. Miller just looking for an opportunity, and unfortunately, I don't think her and the freshman were on the same page there. She was looking to play her in, and the ball was intercepted by the Redhawks. We a throw in Tigers here. Miller looking to turn, intercepted there by Kamini. Scuffs it out of bounds, throw in for the Tigers. Hilton finds Lackey. Vasquez Shields goes out of bounds. Throw in Redhawks. Castle tried to deflect it back. It's intercepted well there by Brady. Brady screaming forward, looking to go one-on-one against Armstrong. I don't think she realized where the out-of-bounds marker was and accidentally dribbled out of bounds there. And with a score line of 5-1, the Martin Methodist Redhawks, ranked number 5 in the nation, are going to continue on their winning streak. They are now 12-0, 6-0 in conference as they go on to beat your Georgetown College Lady Tigers, 5-1, and the Tigers are going to move to 4-4 overall, and they are going to move to 2-4 in the Mid-South Conference. Again, on this senior day, we want to go ahead and thank those last seniors for their wonderful careers here at Georgetown College. 00 Meg Martin, number 8 Kelsey Castle, number 10 Mackenzie Warner, number 14 Olivia Ashby, number 16 Caroline Shy, number 21 Kitty Lackey. Thank you to each of you for all the hard work and everything you have done putting into the Georgetown College women's program. We are thankful for you. We are thankful for all that you do. We also want to just say thank you to the parents and to the fans, to all those who have supported them and led them along the way to make them the people that they are. However, your women are not finished. They are not done, as they have a doubleheader coming again. This Tuesday is going to be a home match here between Cumberland, Tennessee. The men's and women's games are going to be happening here during the night. I believe the women are going to be kicking off at 6 o'clock, and the men are going to be kicking off at 8:30. So we look forward to seeing you all back here at Georgetown College. Please stay on the broadcast as we're going to get ready for a 3:30 kickoff between your Georgetown College men's soccer team as they're going to be playing the same team, Martin Methodist. Again, thank you so much for allowing me to commentate the women's match for you. Hopefully we'll see you all back here in 30 minutes for the men's match. Have a wonderful day. And for those staying on, we'll see you here in just a bit.